tabarnak! It's a little too early for that kind of abuse, huh? Come on.
So, what's next?
We do as the lady says. Focus on the observatory.
Assassins, Templars, crazy talk. I'm curious about this shareholders meeting, though. How about you break into Olivier's office and see if you can find his schedule? Oh, what? You don't like that idea? Well, how about I blow the fucking whistle on you, hacker? I own you! What I mean is, I don't want to ruin your life. So, do as I say. Now, step over to the window. Into Olivier's office through the front door, so I've opened another route. Up we go. Did you know that Abstergo was run by Templars? Oh, yes. Sounds like crackpot stuff, I know. But then again, the moon landing was fake, right? So, anything's possible. All right. Either you walk through that door, or throw yourself off the terrace. Those are your options. Oh, well done, kiddo. Find his computer. Make it snappy. We're looking for the... Be careful now. As the data moves, there are security programs constantly monitoring the data flow. You need to sneak past them, or they will destroy your data and send it back home. Now, get down to the lobby. There's a courier waiting. Yeah, that's right. I've been planning this for a few hours. Now, wait. The receptionist. Hold on. I'll try something. As gullible as ever. Now, hurry down to the lobby before I remotely detonate your earpiece. Don't even think about ratting me out. My tracks are covered. Yours ain't.
Did you, like the allongé?
I practiced.
I think you pulled it a little too long.
Oh, come on! It's not encrypted code, for God's sakes. It's just a bloody coffee. Oh, hooray! It's our old friend.
Hey there. I just got a call about picking up another transfer.
Aw? You said you were here to see me.
Yes, that is one of the perks. Let's see it. A conference in Chicago. Very nice. Thanks for this. We'll be in touch.
Ciao, Rebecca. Text me.
Stuff it, Hastings.
Leur culture d'entreprise me donne envie de vomir.
Well done, friend. Very well done. Apologies for my temper tantrum there. You are with the good guys, I promise. We'll keep you safe. Trust me. Go on back to work. We'll be in touch.
I have an awful feeling about this. You'll be hurt out there. I couldn't handle that.
I'll be careful, I promise. And when I'm flush with coin and set up, I'll send for you. I will.
Caroline, come away! Don't exert yourself!
I can't promise I'll come, Edward. If you leave on this fool's errand, I cannot promise anything.
Don't give up on me, Caroline! Not when I need your faith the most.
Putting some shape to your sentiments?
Just a short letter home. I reckon she's past caring anyway.
Oh, you're a hard heart that should be softer.
Or soft in parts that should be hard.
And how is it you're so keen for his hard parts, Mr. Rackham?
You'd like to know my secrets, would you?
Oh, aye. Give me a small hint, like. Or a large one if you're an upright gentleman.
Open your hand.
Oh!
Who's shooting?
Might be them ships sliding into port.
Jesus.
Well, I'll be hanged. King George has grown tired of our shenanigans.
Who's the grim fella?
That's Captain Woods Rogers. Not a man I want seeing my face.
We desire a parley with the men who call themselves governors of this island. Charles Vane, Ben Hornigold, and Ed Thatch. Come forth, if you please.
Hear about the King's pardon, I reckon.
What the hell is Hornigold doing?
Lily-livered punk!
What are you men up to?
I am grateful for your geniality, Captain Hornigold. I assumed our reception would be a troubled one.
Don't mistake my decorum for deference, Governor. I'm eager to hear what you have to say.
You!
But of uncertain mind otherwise.
Very well put. It's a fairer shape than I expected to see from it. reality, Captain Hornigold. I assumed our reception would be a...
Don't mistake my decorum for deference, Governor. I'm eager to hear what you have to say, but of uncertain mind otherwise.
Very well put. And it's a fairer shake than I expected to see from any pirate. But I promise fair treatment to all who hear me out.
Only wait a while longer, Governor Rogers. These rascals will show their true colors in time.
Grateful for your geniality, Captain Hornigold.
Don't mistake my decorum for deference, Governor. I'm eager to hear what you have to say, but of uncertain mind otherwise.
Very well put. Fair estate that I expect to receive from any pirates. And I promise fair treatment to all who hear me out.
Only wait a while longer,
Governor Rogers.
The rascals will show
their true colors in time.
Calm, Commodore Chamberlain. I have given Captain Hornigold my word that we will be excellent.
Won't do you a lick of good. Men like him are a blight on His Majesty's reputation and a peculiar cancer afflicting the new world. The King wants them eradicated.
I'll beat the bejesus.
Come back here, you mad man!
This sight is mine! Clear shot!
Grateful for your geniality, Captain Hornigold. I assumed our reception would be a trouble for
us. Don't mistake my decorum for deference, Governor. I needed to hear what you have to say. But of uncertain mind otherwise.
Very well put. And it's a fairer shake than I expected to see from any pirate. But I promise fair treatment to all who hear me out.
Only wait a while longer, Governor Rogers. These rascals will show their true colors in time.
Ah, Commodore Chamberlain. I have given Captain Hornigold my word that we will be equitable.
Won't do you a lick of good. Men like him are a blight on His Majesty's reputation and a peculiar cancer. Afflicting the new world. The King wants them eradicated, above all else.
Is this the town square?
As close to one as we've ever had.
Incredible. It's no cleaner than a dog's kennel. Captain Hornigold, please call your men.
Rackham, Vane! The Governor's come calling. Bring Burgess and Corcoran as well.
Man out, lads! And take this shanty town as if it were your own!
Aye. The King has been particularly affected in bringing about this change, hasn't he? Go! Commodore Chamberlain, We see that all merchants, masons, and carpenters are rounded up and brought to me this afternoon. We must see about repairing this fortress.
We should be confiscating weapons, Governor. Send these pirates a clear, strong message that the King's emissaries are not to be trifled with.
I have no wish to stir up animosity here, Commodore. And though well armed, we are outnumbered by a decent margin. Slow persuasion is our best and most efficient weapon.
Twaddle, Governor! We should sink every goddamn ship not flying the King's colors. To do otherwise projects a certain weakness in our bearing.
Silence, Commodore! I am a goddamn governor here, serving at the King's pleasure, and I will make the bloody decisions. Is that clear, sir?
Aye, sir. Your wishes are clear as crystal.
These are the charts, Commodore. We're in position.
Governor Rogers believes he can make men of these monkeys yet. I do not. Return to your post and await my orders.
Listen to your bitch.
Surrender him or themselves to any one of the principal secretaries of state in Great Britain or Ireland, or to any governor or deputy governor of any of our plantations beyond the sea. Every such tyrant and pirate shall surrender in him or themselves, as aforesaid, shall have our gracious pardon. Of and for such his or their piracy or pirates his. All them committed before the 5th of January, next and you shall hereby strictly charge and command all our admirals, captains, and other officers at sea, and all our governors and commanders of any force,
castle or other places in our plantations, and all our officers, civil and military, to seize and take such of the pirates who shall refuse or neglect to surrender themselves accordingly. Shall on or before the 5th of September, in the year of our Lord 1718, surrender him or themselves to any one of the principal secretaries of state, Great Britain or Ireland, or to any governor or deputy governor of any of our plantations beyond the seas, every such pirate and pirate so surrendering him or themselves, as aforesaid, shall have our gracious pardon. Of and for such his or their piracy or pirates, by him or them committed before the 5th of January next ensuing, and we do hereby strictly charge and command all our admirals, captains, and other officers at sea, and all our governors and commanders of any port, or other places in our plantations, and all our officers, civil and military, to seize and take such of the pirates who shall refuse or neglect to surrender themselves accordingly.
Stop, I want to talk to you.
I enjoy this.
Oh, I've got a lovely clear shot.
Virginia. Thank you.
I pray you take the prudent course, gentlemen, and accept the king's pardon as soon as your hearts allow. For until such time, all of you will be confined in Nassau. I am sorry for this, but in lieu of a public trial, this pardon is your best bet.
The governor puts it far too brightly, maggots. Take this message home. Accept the king's protection forthwith, or we will raise this town to its foundation and stretch your bloody necks.
Peace! Commodore Chamberlain, we are messengers, not executioners. Not yet.
Oh, thank you, sir. God save you.
Look on this as a stroke of fortune, lads. We should take the king's pardon and salvage what dignity we
Peace.
Own.
I'll be hanged before I surrender to that bobbin.
Check your head, Vane. We had here a rare opportunity, a chance to take something base and shape it into a government made and maintained by men of vision. But in 2 years, we pissed it away. I won't make that mistake again.
It's truth he's telling, and you whelps can't handle it. Adieu, you forecastle-headed fuddlers. See you at the gallows.
You'll all be dead, men! Bastards!
I need a drink.
Intruder! I need some help here!
To think on how many times I've put up with Hornigold and his self-righteous shite.
Verily, you are a man of principle, Captain Hornigold. A man I believe I can trust with my best ideas.
Faith, and we'll survive this, Charles, with our pride intact.
Well, that's confidence. You brewed a plan I might get a taste of?
Nassau is over, that's plain to see. I say we skip out tonight and regroup at my compound.
Fair enough. What's your angle?
The Brits have brought their supplies ashore, see? If we nick some gunpowder and pine pitch, we can build a fire ship and send it straight at the blockade, blasting it to smithereens.
Aye. We'll use Rackham's ship. You ain't a capable captain.
My conscience is clear.
Right. When you get the gunpowder, I'll secure the pine pitch.
Thank you.
coward! It's me you have always much. Hello, good people. Let you all this way.
You! He's making a run for it.
Hold mine. He's mine!
Hurry up, lads! He's trying to play us! He's in my sight! Lads, hurry me! You're not losing us! Faster! Hold mine. You're not losing this. Faster.
You! Halt!
Come on, then! Clear shot. Jack. Here's the bomb.